I talked with several of you, and we asked each other a lot of questions. I asked you questions, you asked me questions, and an idea for a song started brewing then. And since I saw you last Saturday, I wrote this song. And I just finished writing this song, the fourth or fifth rewrite this morning, so that's why I've got to have the cards to remind myself of what the words are, the last version I wrote. This song is a very personal thing, I suppose you might say, but it's the way I feel about a lot of things. This song is called...
What is going down, world? A welcome to the 40-year-old FUQ Boys podcast. I go by the name Black Pegasus, and I am excited for this one. Now, a ton of you guys have asked me, hey, check out Johnny Cash, The Man in Black. Now, a little... To preface all this for people who aren't familiar with me, I'm a rapper, hip-hop head, been rapping for a long time, have had a pretty good rap career, underground, independent rap career, and I never really got into Johnny Cash. I knew of Walk the Line. I'm still not sure if I know Ring of Fire. That sounds, I think I know, but that's it. And I got acquainted to Johnny Cash with Hurt. Right as he's going out, I reacted to that, and it really touched my soul. So I was like, man, I'm going on a journey. And we reacted to a boy named Sue. God's gonna cut you down. And I just can't believe how incredible Johnny Cash is and how long I've been missing out on this legend icon. Now I'm getting excited. Mad people, you gotta check out The Man in Black. Yo, he wears black because... You know, he connects to the downtrodden and, you know, the poor and the people, the have-nots. He's the people's champ. And I was like, okay, I like this. I like where this is going. The Man in Black, the Black Pegasus, okay. But anyway, just hearing what he just said is incredible, you guys. Because I'm a hip-hop artist, rapper. I have songs. But I also do freestyle rap as improv. And when he says, I just rewrote this four or five times, so I have to have, like, cue cards, like bullet points, while I'm performing. But it's so important for me to perform it now. Oh, boy, what are we about to get here? And from everything I've seen from Johnny Cash, I expect nothing but fantasticness, amazingness, exceptionalism. Let's go. Like, share, comment, subscribe. 40.
40-year-old punk boys are back in town. 40. Boys are back in town. 40-year-old punk boys are back in town. Boys are back in town.
40-year-old FUQ Boys podcast. Malt liquor for your ears. 40.
All right, y'all, let me get this logo down. Pull the video up. Don't forget, support the original content on the channel. I'm a hip-hop artist, so I got some rap stuff, rip it a rap, some new music videos out and stuff like that. But I've been vlogging, doing some travel vlogging, food challenges, sketches, stuff like that. So I really want to spend 2024 figuring out my niche with original content so I can add that as a pillar to the channel. Of course, I got music on the channel and reactions, and that's amazing, and we're going to keep rocking with that. But yeah, let's get it. I'm very excited. I'm going to start this back from the beginning and let's go. This is Johnny Cash, Man in Black, the best of the Johnny Cash TV show. Wow. So he had a TV show. Man, this dude's remarkable. Ahead of his time. Ahead of his time, I take it. Man, too bad I was so late to the party. Wow. All right, here we go.
Just look around the other day. I talked with several of you, and we asked each other a lot of questions. I asked you questions. You asked me questions. And an idea for a song started brewing then. And since I saw you last Saturday, I wrote this song. And I just finished writing this song, the fourth or fifth rewrite this morning, so that's why I've got to have the cards to remind myself of what the words are, the last version I wrote. This song is a very personal thing, I suppose you might say, but it's the way I feel about a lot of things. This song is called The Man in Black. Well, you wonder why I always dress in black. Why you never see bright colors on my back. And why does my appearance always have a somber tone? Well, there's a reason for the things that I have on. I wear the black for the poor and the beaten down. Living in the hopeless, hungry side of town. and I wear it for the prisoner who has long paid for his crime, but still is there because he's a victim of the times. I wear the black for those who've never read or listened to the words that Jesus said about the road to happiness through love and charity. Why, you'd think he's talking straight to you and me. Well, we're doing mighty fine, I do suppose, in our streak of lightning cars and fancy clothes. But just so we're reminded of the ones who are held back, up front there ought to be a man in black. I wear it for the sick and lonely old.
Jeez. Damn. Johnny Cash is a real one. Johnny Cash is a real one. Bro, why does Johnny Cash choke me up? I don't know if it's because he's gone. I don't know if it's because the message resonates so deep in my core. I don't know if it's just because I'm watching the Genuine article that, you know, it's not every day you get to witness this type of greatness. And it's weird because it's just like knowing somebody cares. Knowing at the height of your fame, your career, your wealth, and you still represent for the underdogs. And you still understand the complexity of, like, people changing. Because, you know, a lot of people, yo, lock them up, put them under the jail, da-da-da-da, right? And some crimes call for that. But people do change. And we mature. That's what you're seeing here in front of you. I only listen to rap, R&B, you know, little stuff out of bounds. But, it's just a rap hip-hop kid, rebellious, getting in trouble, doing dumb stuff in the streets. You name it, I was doing it. And I matured, and I grew up, and I have a family now. And I protect and provide for my family. And it's crazy to hear someone like this. And when I say this, I'm not putting him in a box. It's just really cool to see someone who cares about the underdog and the underdogs. I don't know why. It's making me somewhat emotional. There goes stoicism. Nah, I can remain stoic as he is. He's stoic. That's what's crazy about Johnny Cash. He's stoic. He's a man's man. Believes in God, man. Oh, my goodness. Thank goodness. You know, sometimes I lose hope, and I forget there's a lot of people who were touched by Johnny Cash, and I didn't know this was the messaging. I had no clue, and this is good stuff. This is good stuff. He's not perfect. He's imperfect. He out here rapping Cocaine Blues, we reacted. That song's crazy as hell. This dude, wow, the man in black, okay? And he came up with this song after talking to all these people. How much more real does it get? And it's almost like he's not even singing. It's almost like he's talking to you. Then he kind of gets to a little singing part. It's almost like a rap, if we're keeping it honest. Like, he's just talking to you. Man, this is amazing. This is great.
Up front, there ought to be a man in black. I wear it for the sick and lonely old. For the reckless ones whose bad trip left them cold. I wear the black in mourning for the lives that could have been. Each week we lose 100 fine young men. And yes, I wear it for the thousands who have died, believing that the Lord was on their side. And I wear it for another 100,000 who have died, believing that we all were on their side. Well, there's things that never will be right, I know. And things need changing everywhere you go. But till we start to make a move, to make a few things right, You'll never see me wear a suit of white. I'd love to wear a rainbow every day to tell the world that everything's okay. But maybe I can carry off a little darkness on my back till things are brighter. I'm the man in black.
I'm in shock. I don't even know what to say. I don't know how I haven't heard that song before. I don't know how I don't know more about Johnny Cash. It's almost embarrassing in a sense. It's funny because the end of that song, you know, it's funny because I personally wore black a lot. I stopped wearing black. I'm wearing black right now, but I like to wear more colorful things because sometimes I feel like colors, sounds, frequencies, like I want to just get to a higher vibration because I'm a worry wart. I worry about everything. I'm concerned and da-da-da-da, and sometimes I'm like, hey. And you know the stuff he said about the rainbow, right? The rainbow comes after the storm. That's what he's talking about. In this day and age, if you're in 2023, the rainbow could mean a whole lot of things, right? But essentially, the rainbow comes after the storm. That's what it, you know, for some of us, it was God's promise. But the rainbow comes after the storm, right? And that's what he's talking about. But until things, you know, come back to balance or restore to right, he's saying he's going to wear black. And you know, it reminds me of the story that, you know, choked me up with Angelina Jordan. Yeah. Where she doesn't wear shoes when she performs. She doesn't wear shoes because I guess she went to like a third world country and saw that kids couldn't afford shoes. And she's like, I'll never wear shoes in a performance until, you know, children all over the world have shoes. And there's these little things that artists do that are very important. What he just did with this song here and said was very important. That message will stand the test of time. I'm here in 2023. I don't know when that was, but you know, you're looking at the television, it's right after TV was black and white and just barely went to color. So this is, and it touched me in 2023. This is what the power we have when we create art and music. It lasts longer than us because it lives through people, and now it lives through these digital spaces. Johnny Cash, you're the man. God, wish I would have known about you before you passed, and you know, but hey, better late than never, right? Johnny Cash, the man in black, has left me speechless. That was great. I should be excited. That was great. I just it wasn't great in the way where I do a backflip on this channel and oversell something with laughter or that meant something. It meant something to me. Touched me. That was great. All right, you guys. Like, share, comment, subscribe. If you rock with the vibe, you know what to do.
Thank you for being some man. 40 years down the road, back again. 40. FUQ boy.